Hi, it's Jamie, Progressive's Employee of the Month, 2 months in a row. Leave a message at the...
Hi, Jamie. It's me, Jamie. I just had a new idea for our song about the Name Your Price tool. So when it's like, tell us what you want to pay, hey, 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 and the trombone goes, blah, 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 and you say, we'll help you find coverage options to fit your budget. Then we just all do finger snaps while a choir goes, savings coming at ya, savings coming at ya. Yes? No? Maybe? Anyway, see you at practice tonight. I got new lyrics for the rap break.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Blog Talk Radio.
You are listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio, and this is Quatita Dean, your host. This is Soul Sessions Live. This is a show you must hear and see to believe. I have helped so many people connect with their loved ones to get the closure they deeply desired. This is my passion, and I can't wait to take you on a walk with the ancestors. Tune in each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You are listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio, and this is Quatita Dean, your host. This is Soul Sessions Live. This is a show you must hear and see to believe. I have helped so many people connect with their loved ones to get the closure they deeply desired. This is my passion, and I can't wait to take you on a walk with the ancestors. Tune in each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m., Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hi, this is Quatita Dean, your host. You are listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio, and this is Soul Sessions Live. Y'all know what we do. We come on and we connect those to their loved ones who may need some immediate messages or healing. We got a great show lined up for y'all. I'm just so excited about everything. So thank you for joining us. Remember, we're here each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to go ahead and get started. We got some hot topics. We got hot tea. We got a guest reader in the house. She's not actually in the house, but she is on the line. Her name is Jasmine Bell. She goes by Jazz the Medium. You may know her, heard of her, seen her work. She is awesome. We're going to get right to it. So we're going to go ahead and start with our hot topics, y'all. You are listening to Soul Sessions Live. Get ready for these hot topics. Let's get it. All right. So listen, we got some good hot topics for y'all tonight. I want to start off by talking about something. You know, I love to do celebrity hot topics, but I have a few of those, but we're going to also go in because there is this young lady by the name of Amy Acevedo, if I'm saying her name correctly. December 9th, her house caught on fire. Her five children were caught in her house where she was not able to get to them. Killing all five of her children. The young lady is currently in the hospital. There's just so much going on. But this is why I wanted to talk about it and bring it to the forefront, right? Because this young woman lost all of her children. Her home caught fire. She was not able to get to her children. Do you know people are dragging this woman, saying, you know, cussing her out, talking about, oh, bitch, I would have died with my kids. Listen, you don't know what you would do in a situation such as that. Because, yes, we love our children. Yes, we will go to the ends of the earth for our children. But when you are in a situation like that, you don't know what you would do. And for them to be, like, in on this woman, I think is bullshit. But I did see today or hear today that there was some people that donated a few things, gave her some flowers, you know, really said some prayers for this young woman. She is fairly young, but I know she has five children. She had a set of twins. And not to be so graphic about it, but listen, her set of twins, they said, was incinerated. So if you know what that word is, that means her children were burnt. They did not die from smoke inhalation. There were also two firefighters that were actually hurt as well, trying to save this woman's children. She was heard in the background on a 911 call, you know, screaming, somebody please help my children. And for people to be going in on this lady is ridiculous. So let me tell you something, because I've been in that situation before. My daughter was 3 weeks old, okay, approximately 3 weeks to a month old. And so my cousin was like, you know, you need to get out the house. Let's go somewhere. Because I'd never went anywhere before I got pregnant, you know. And so I agreed. So we took her to the babysitter, leaving where we went to, because we didn't go to the club or no. We just kind of was out, you know, having a good time. Our car caught on fire. All I saw was smoke. Seeing the smoke in the car, like, I don't know what happened. I heard a noise, like, boom. The car was engulfed with smoke. I jumped straight out the car. I forgot I had a three-week-old baby in the back seat. My cousin Sarita was in the back seat. My cousin Minnie was driving. I jumped straight out the car, slammed the door, boom, and took off. I looked back and realized, oh, shit, my baby. I looked back. My cousin is climbing out the window with my daughter in her arms. You cannot tell me or judge this woman if you don't know what you would do. You know what I'm saying? And that was just quick
in a car. You feel me? So don't say what this woman should have done because you don't know. You've never been put in that situation. If you have, then I hope to God that everything will work out for you. But please be careful about what you say about people and the things that you would do because you don't know what you would do. I've been in a situation where I said, if this ever happened to me, I would do X, Y, Z. And when it happened to me, I did not do X, Y, Z. So you can't say what you would do situation. I want to just lift that queen up right now in prayer to the spirit and to the ancestors that, you know, they helped her through this time. My condolences to the queen. And, you know, we just send love out to her. So we just wanted to speak on that real quick, you know. So we're going to go ahead and go forward on into our celebrity news hot topics portion of it. So Lisa Ray signs a deal for creative screenwriters,
yes,
which is awesome. Go ahead, Hati. Help us understand what's going on with that.
So Issa Rae, you know, she created
Issa Rae.
Yes.
Oh.
She created her show Insecure, you know what I mean?
Mm.
And, you know, that blew up, and she has a company, Color Creative, for, you know, creative writers. And she recently just signed a deal with Columbia Pictures to bring in creative, different, basically the underdog of writers that, you know, don't really get shine or
mm-hmm.
may not have that kind of money to be able to present their ideas to a big company as Columbia. So I think that's really good that she's going to be able to give these kind of people a shot, because if people didn't know that Black Panther was not, you know,
they didn't even want to do Black Panther.
They said that was a underrated. They didn't think it was going to do as well as it did.
Yeah, you see what it did. It did numbers
it did.
In the box office. It did numbers. It's trying to reconnect for whatever reason. Doing numbers in the box office, or it did numbers in the box office.
So, you know, that just goes to show that you cannot skip those people who is not as fortunate, you know, to be able to be able to express themselves creatively.
So if you know anyone that is wanting to is screenwriters or anything like that, please have them look into that. Issa Rae, you know, her thing. So also our Facebook viewer Alexis Imani says she's going to be induced tonight. Pray for her.
Okay.
So we are sending love and prayers to her from the ancestors. So we're so grateful for that. Congratulations on that. We know you're going to be good, Alexa. And I hope you give birth at 5 a.m. Also, so we want to talk about Ty Dolla $ign and Benzino.
Yes.
They both are facing time for drug possession.
Yes, they're facing up to 15 years.
15 years. How do you go and do these things? Like, I don't know. Allegedly, 15 years for drug possession. If you get that kind of money and you still see nothing but drugs in your future, then I don't know what the fuck to tell you.
Right.
I
mean,
it's ridiculous.
Especially like Ty Dolla $ign was caught with cocaine, and he had under an ounce of weed on him. So, you know, they didn't hit him with two different felony. It was something else too that they hit him with, you know, and that's racking up to 15 years. And also, Benzino just was hit with a felony drug possession charge, and he's facing up to 15 years. And I was
please go sit down.
You know what I mean?
Go sit down.
Like, you should have had more weed than you had.
You should have had more. You're going to smoke your weed. You should have had more weed than you had any coke. Why'd you have coke at all? Are you a cocaine user?
What is that?
I don't know. But anyway, that's our hot topics, y'all. We're going to go ahead and we're going to take a quick break. We're going to get Miss Hot Tea. We're trying to implement more structure into the show, y'all. So we're going to go into a break. We're going to get Miss Hot Tea, and then we got Miss Jasmine Bell on the line. She's going to do some readings tonight, y'all.
Got an event or going out on the town? Not sure what to wear? Reach out to stylist Asia Jarice. Asia Jarice at iCloud.com or Asia Jarice on Instagram. That is AsiaJurice. Styling Nashville's elite. You are listening to Soul Sessions Live, right here on A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. I am your host, Quatita Dean. Tune in each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where the music is always right and so are the messages. You can call in and get your personal reading and message from Spirit each and every Wednesday and Sunday. Make sure you tune in. Yeah. Hey, ladies. It's Hot Tea. I'm back with some more makeup tips. Make sure that you're tuning in. You don't want to miss this tea.
All right. We are back. We're going straight into Hot Tea tips. What is going on, Ms. Hot Tea? How are you?
I'm good.
So, listen, you had your demo today at Sephora.
I did.
So, how did that go for you?
It was great. I went in there and I was confident. Of course, I was a little nervous in the beginning, but once I got in the groove of it, you know, it was cool and they was able to give me great feedback. I learned a lot. And so I'm excited. I know I got the job. I'm putting it out there.
You're putting it out there in the universe. So fingers crossed for Ms. Hot Tea. Trying to get that land that beautiful job at Sephora. What do you have for us today, Ms. Hot Tea? What tips you got?
I got 8 quick tips to good soft skin in the winter.
Okay. How to keep that skin
how
good
to
during
the
cold.
Yes. And looking great. So the first thing that I want to tell you ladies is to make sure when you wash your face that you are washing it in lukewarm water, right? Also, you want to make sure that you are moisturizing immediately after your moisturizer of choice. The third tip is make sure that you choose your moisturizer health carefully. So, like, if you have oily skin, make sure that you have something that, you know, caters to that. If you have dry skin, make sure that you have something that caters to that.
I have very dry skin.
Yes. You also want to make sure that you are protecting your skin. And again, that goes into moisturizing it up, priming it up. Just making sure that your skin is very dehydrated this winter. Also, I'm
hydrated.
Hydrated. Say dehydrated.
Yeah.
Hydrated. Also, the fifth tip is if you have a humidifier, that's really good to have in the winter in your room for your skin. Just, you know, that's that extra oomph of keeping that moisture in the skin and keeping it good and hydrated.
Okay.
So you want to make sure that you're drinking a lot of water.
Oh, yes. Water is good for the face and for the body.
Yes, right. So, yeah, make sure that you're drinking a lot of water. And tip 7, make sure that you're using overnight moisturizers. It is okay to moisturize your face at night. So
okay.
Sleep is, you know, it's in there. It's locking in that moisture.
Okay.
And the last tip is exfoliate.
Ooh.
You want to make sure that we're exfoliating, getting that dead skin off, and keeping that skin nice, clean, and healthy.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Hot Tea. Some of those good tips. I'm going to put them to use. We're going to go into the phone lines. We're going to take another quick break briefly. Well, as soon as we come back, we're hitting the phone lines. We got Jasmine Bell. Jazz the medium. She's going to set the phone lines on fire. So we'll be right back. Get ready. Make sure you're calling in. 563-999-3422.
Hey, ladies. It's Hot Tea. I'm back with some more makeup tips. Make sure that you're tuning in. You don't want to miss this tea. Do you need promotion to advertise your business, get your music played on the radio, or promote an event? Reach out to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. We're looking for sponsorship. We have great packages right here. You can get anything you need for all your promotional needs. Reach out to Quatita Dean at 513-328-0061.
I'ma play the corners with a husband. I told him, please don't die over the neighborhood that your mama rentin'. Take your drug money and buy the neighborhood. That's how you rent it. I bought every V12 engine. Wish I could take it back to the beginning. I could have bought a place in Dumbo before it was Dumbo for like $2 million. That same building today it's worth $25 million. Guess how I'm feeling? Dumbo. Light nigga, dark nigga, faux nigga, real nigga, rich nigga, poor nigga, house nigga, feel nigga. Still nigga.
Radio. This is Soul Sessions Live, and I'm your host, Quatita Dean. We have a good show for you tonight, but make sure you check us out each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Listen, we're going right into the phone lines. We got Jasmine Bell on the line. She's going to be doing some readings tonight. Jazz?
Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, Queen, how are you?
I am awesome. I'm honored to be on the show.
You know, I love you. I'm trying to put everything where I'm going. I'm trying to take you and my spirit with me. So I'm just like, let's get it, you know? So, we got a lot to Yeah. So if you're ready, I'm ready. We're going to open up the phone lines for you. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right. So, first caller you got, caller last four digits is 1920.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey.
How are you?
Good.
What's your name?
Nalisha.
Hey, would you like a brief mediumship reading, or did you have any questions?
Well, I did, but I'll just take whatever you got. It's crazy. I was first. I've been trying for the last couple of weeks.
Is that what brought you surprised because you were first? Okay. As far as ancestors go, I have a gentleman here for you. I feel like he's kind of on the heavy side, probably got a bit of a belly. He almost feels like a grandfather. Did your grandfather pass?
I don't know my grandfather. I've never met him either, on either side, my mom or my dad.
Either side?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let me push him to the side because he's the first one that came in. This is definitely a grandfather figure. Is there anyone that you would like to reach in particular? Because you've got a lot of people here.
Well, no, like my grandmother and my son. I just, for the last couple of weeks, I've been having just some issues. I was told that when my son died that he had a baby on the way. And I'm not going to say too much, like, on the radio, but I will say that there is a baby that I believe is his. But I kind of try to leave it alone because his dad is incarcerated, and he told me that he'll just handle it once he get out. But, like, it's another one, too, that he knew about before he died, but I'm not really sure if I think that one is his or not. I just wanted to know if what I was feeling about the one that I do think is his is, like, coming out headed, like, in the right direction, or should I just leave it alone?
It's weird that you say that because the one that I'm feeling that you think is his may not switch him around. So basically the one that you think may be his, I feel like may not be, and the one that you think isn't his, there's a good possibility that there can be. And that's okay. What I'm feeling in my gut. I'm really feeling like it's the opposite way around. I kind of got a ping on the one that you said might not be his. That's the one I got a ping on, like, okay, that's his. So
okay.
There's a possibility for both, but I definitely think that the one that you don't think is his is a good possibility that the child can be his. That's what I feel.
Okay.
Quatita, you got any input on that one?
I think she told me the same thing. She's probably going about to tell me she told me the same thing.
I completely agree that I think that's the one that's actually his, the one you don't think is his. You got anything else for Jazz?
No, just whatever you got in general. That was just what I've been trying to, I don't know.
Okay, Jazz, you got anything else you need to give her?
Question for you. I feel like something new is coming along. Are you looking for new employment? Are you looking for a new job?
No. No, but I haven't been working since my son died. I've gone back to work at the beginning of the year.
Okay, so then that's what I'm picking up. I'm seeing something new.
But I don't want to go there. Like, my old job is definitely open, but I don't know if I want to go back there or not. I know that I will if all else fails, but I don't want to go back there.
Okay, yeah, I see something new. I see something new coming up for you. I see something. I see a new job coming up for you. My advice for you, though, would be to, I think it's been very difficult for you since your son died, and I'm not going to go personal because we're not on the air, because we're on the air, but I want you to try your best to work on kind of separating, because you don't want to bring home to work. Because, you know, sometimes when we go through so many things, we kind of carry it to work with us, and that's what my spirit is telling me to tell you, to kind of like, try to put yourself in a different headspace when you go to work, and you can be very successful with it. I don't know if you have any business ideas. I feel like there's a – are you writing a book?
That's what I was going to ask, yes. And I was going to ask,
yes.
Am I going to be working for myself or somebody else? Did you see that? I prefer to work for myself, and I don't even care to make an astronomical amount of money. I just want to be well off, but I want to work for myself, and I know that – yeah, I am writing a book, but do you call
it? Yeah, I feel a book coming, but I also feel you, I do feel you working for yourself, but I do feel like it has something to do in your son's memory. So however your son died, and I don't want to say it on, I really feel, can I say it? I really feel suicide.
Yeah. It is.
And I think that you're going to be able to help a lot of people and make money while doing that because of your struggle and what you went through.
that I'm kind of speechless because I'm a big procrastinator. I see that too. But I always said that that's what I wanted to do. Like, and just with the growing number amount of suicides and stuff, that's what I see myself. I see myself writing this book later. I'm trying to get better with that. I see myself finishing this month, and I want to travel. I want to go, like, to different cities and states, to school, to kind of, like, even though I don't have, like, a degree or anything, like, I feel like what better person to be able to get across to kids and even adults about suicide and from my personal experience, you know. I do want to do that. I'm not going to put that in past tense. I do want to do that. That's something that I've been thinking about for a while.
Okay. I'm a fire sign, so I'm going to put a little fire up under your butt, okay? It starts with you, okay? So every day you need to sit down and plan something towards your goal. Every day sit down and start small, because the small steps lead up to the big steps. But you can't just sit around wishing and hoping and dreaming, and there's so many people out there you can help. You need to start now. So every day, start writing down ideas, start looking in the program, start networking and contacting people, because I have a feeling you tend to turtle a little bit or hermit a little bit. You know,
I do.
Come on out and try to connect with people and start writing down something that you need to accomplish at least every day, whether it's posting something on Facebook about suicide, or writing articles, or blogging, or typing in your book every day, or talking and connecting with other people who have had children that passed from the same thing. Just start putting yourself out there.
Okay.
And that would be my advice for you. Do something every day.
Thanks.
Every day.
Thank
well,
you.
Right. That was so
yeah,
awesome.
Thanks.
Thank you. Melissa, we'll be hollering at you. Thank you for that, okay?
Okay, thanks.
All right. Oh, Jazz, that was so awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Oh, my God. You have no idea.
Her energy feels so beautiful. I feel like I met her. Have I met her before?
She actually came to the event when you and my sister, you all were here. She was there as well.
She felt familiar.
Yeah,
familiar.
So we got another call for you. Call
okay.
And anytime to break, Jasmine, you let me know, okay?
Okay.
We got another call for you. Last four digits is 5081. Hi, caller. Who do we have on the line? You want to talk to Jazz the medium?
Yes.
Hi. What's your name?
Hi. This is Yolanda.
Hey, Yolanda, would you like me to pull an ancestor for you, or do you have a question for me?
It doesn't really matter, but, yeah, let me ask you a question.
Okay.
Future-wise, career-wise, business-wise, are you seeing anything for me?
Career-wise, Yolanda,
mm-hmm.
Hold on, let me connect to you. Immediately off the back, I got the medical field. Are you in the medical field?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, immediately I'm connecting with you doing something in the medical field. How do you feel about nursing?
I am a nurse.
Yeah, that's where I see your career path in. I actually see you pushing forward into there's two different things I'm seeing for you.
Ooh.
The first thing I'm seeing for you is I'm hearing management or supervisor, if you're not already, but management. But the second thing I'm hearing from you is your own business. Have you considered, like, your own agency?
Oh, Jesus Christ. I am working right now. I have an agency. I have everything set up in place. I just don't have any clients yet. And I'm starting with private pay before I'm able to actually be able to do Medicare, Medicaid. And I'm also in the process of opening up a uniform store.
Okay. Yeah. I can tell you right now, of course, you know, because you don't have any clients yet, of course, it's going to start off slow. but it's going to do well. Okay, it's going to do well. My only advice for you would be watch your money management.
Mm-hmm.
Management. Watch your money management. If you can put something up, put something up. But my spirit is definitely telling you to, you know, be a little bit more frugal with how you manage your finances. But you should be okay. That's definitely what I see you doing. But until you build, I see you, and it might be through your agency, but I see you working in a high position.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. That's all right. What I got for you.
That's all right. Well, I'm trying to tell y'all how wonderful this woman is. You don't quite get it. Thank you, Ms. Honda. We really appreciate you calling in to speak with Jazz.
Thank you. I appreciate you ladies both.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Jazz, I got to keep going. Are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine. You know, my goal is to touch as many people as I can. So if I seem like I'm very quick with my answers, I know there's probably people that want to be talked to. So I don't want to spend too much time. You know what I mean? So
yes.
We're going to try to go quickly so we can get as many people as we can, you know. So we'll just try to be respectful of everyone's time.
All right. So we're going to try to get as many people in as possible. Jazz, your next caller, last four digits is 7043. I'm trying to keep track as well. Who do we have on the line, caller?
My name is Shanice.
Hi, Shanti.
Shanice,
I'm sorry, Shanice.
You fine.
Did you have a question for me, or did you want me to try to connect you with an ancestor?
A little of both. I really don't have a question. Just like an overall reading.
What's your question? You don't have a question
really
in particular?
Yeah, just an overall reading.
Okay, I'm going to touch on one area, and for some reason for you, your love life is hopping out on me. Is there something going on in your love life?
Yes.
Yeah. My symbol for love life, for you, what I'm seeing is, and my symbols are weird, y'all, okay, they weird, but I see a Jeep, and it's driving over rocky terrain, which means it's kind of rocky right now. Am I correct?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, for you, this is what I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to be vague because I don't like to get personal on the radio. There's a door open for you, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you have a choice. You could keep on driving on this rocky terrain, or you can step through that door. And if you step through that door, there's somebody waiting for you. It's all about choice.
Really?
Yep.
So the door, so when you say the door, is it somebody that's already in my life or somebody that I'll meet?
See, the thing with that, a lot of people don't understand, is sometimes we can block our blessings, or somebody in our life can block our blessings. And, you know, I'm not trying to tell you what to do, but the person that you're with might not be the situation that you're in might not be the best situation for you. You get what I'm
right.
trying to say? So
right.
if you... I call it call your power back and take authority back and focus on the most important thing that you have, which is yourself. Step through
right.
that door, step out on faith. Something better is coming.
Okay. Do you see anything else for me, like, as far as career-wise?
You thinking about going to school?
Yes.
How do you feel about kids?
I'm currently an educator. But I currently work with kids now. I said I'm currently an educator. Yes.
Uh-huh. I see your future with children. When I feel your energy, you sound young, but you have like a motherly energy to you. So children cling to you, kids like you.
Right.
So if I were you, I would consider working with children. You have a knack with them. You have a way of getting to them. You have a way of connecting with them. And honestly, it takes a special person to connect with children. And I think right. you have that ability.
Now, like, in a, I was going through the process of trying to open my own center. Like, do you see that anywhere?
Definitely a possibility for you. But like I said, you need to clear some of these blocks so you can see your path. But definitely
right.
I see that for you.
Okay.
Okay. I'm telling you, step out on faith. Choose you.
I think
that's my if I give you any advice today, it's choose you. Choose you.
I hear you.
Thank you, Ms. Shanice, for calling in, talking to Ms. Jazz. Appreciate you. All the best to you. And we're going to go ahead and go on to the phone line. So thank you again, Ms. Shanice.
Thank you.
All right. So listen, Jazz.
Yeah.
Please tell them they can find you, reach you, you know what I mean? If they want a personal session with you.
If you would like a personal session with me, you can find me on my webpage at www.jazzthemedium.com. You can also like my webpage, my Facebook page, Jazz the Medium. In the upcoming future, I will be offering, you know, surprise gifts and running specials. This month I'm running a special, but this will probably be the last month I'll be running a special for a while, so get in while you can. www.jazzthemedium.com.
All right, we're going to give you a second. We're going to take a quick break. We come back in, go straight back into the phone lines, okay, Jazz?
All right. Thank you.
When we come back, we're going straight back into the phone lines. So if you want that session with Jazz the Medium, make sure you're calling in 563-999-3422. Hey, you're listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. I am your host, Quatita Dean, and this is Soul Sessions Live. You can find me on Facebook at Quatita, Yes, I Am a Queen Dean, on IG at queens_domain1, or you can call or text 513-328-0061 to schedule your appointment today. Remember, heaven is only a call away.
Got an event or going out on the town? Not sure what to wear? Reach out to stylist Asia Jarice. Asia Jarice at iCloud.com or Asia Jarice on Instagram. That is AsiaJurice, styling Nashville's elite.
All right, you guys, we are back, and we are back here with Jazz the Medium. She's doing some readings for us tonight. Listen, when I tell y'all she's a monster, I am not kidding. Like, she's one of my favorite mediums in the world. So I just kind of want to just touch her ass on the shoulder so I can get some of that juice you come with, Jazz. So we're going to jump right back on to the phone line for you. Let's see where we're going. Last four digits is 8633. Who do we have on the line want to talk to Jazz?
Hey, this is Ms. Reynolds.
Hi, Ms. Reynolds. How are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
Doing well. Do you have a question for me, or would you like to get in contact with a deceased ancestor?
I'm going to say get in contact with my mom. She's been kind of showing up in my dreams for the last week or so. So I don't know whether she's trying to tell me something or what's going on with that.
Okay. I think I got a woman here. I got two women here for you. So let's try to figure out which one your mother is.
Okay.
Was your mother in the church?
Off and on. She was a very spiritual person, but she didn't go every Sunday. No.
Okay. Okay. So I got two women here. I have one woman here. She doesn't look like she's that tall. She doesn't feel tall to me, but that's not always it. She's kind of brown skin. I almost feel as if she's got some glasses on. And this woman here may have wore wigs at one time or another. Does she sound familiar to you?
No. I mean, my mom, she's short, kind of wear glasses, but she hated wigs. I mean, she didn't wear them.
Okay, that can be symbolic for something else.
Okay.
Let me see what else she's giving me. She's making, this woman right here, that's right here, she's making reference to a younger boy. Do you have a son or grandson?
Yes. Yeah. I have a son and grandson. One son, one grandson.
Okay. Which one would be around, okay, she's giving me the number 8. Which one would be close to 8? So whenever I say 8, it could be anywhere from 8 to 10.
8 to 10 would be neither. My son is an adult, and his baby is 1, so.
Okay, because she's, okay, I need to figure, hold on.
Okay.
So I'm seeing a little boy, he's light-skinned, he's about 8 to 10, she's showing me. Okay, let's look at this other woman. This is probably not your mother. Did your mom keep her hair short?
She went back and forth. She had long hair, but she would cut it off in a second.
I got her. She's here. I got her. She knows herself. Okay, I'm sorry. It took me a moment to come through.
Okay.
Let me see what she's telling me. How you been feeling?
Me?
Yeah, you.
Tired, working a lot.
She's telling me to tell you that you're doing too much.
Okay.
She's telling me to tell you that you're taking too much on your shoulders, and she wants you to let some of that load off. Are there any things that you're doing right now that you can kind of avoid doing?
No. I mean, I'm just working. Too many work.
She says you're doing too much. It's going to affect you. Question, do you know if heart problems go through your family?
Heart, no. Her sister has heart problems, but that's it.
Do you get your blood pressure and stuff checked periodically?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what she's concerned about. She's concerned that you might be too stressed and you might be doing too much.
Okay.
And that's kind of what I'm getting from her. She's making me feel like she's kind of making me feel like you're just tired. And, you know, she feels as if you need more help. You're just tired. You're doing too much. But the reason why she's coming to you because she feels as if it's going to affect your physical body. And it's already kind of affecting your spirit.
Okay. Okay.
That's the message that I'm getting from her. Let me get with her to make sure I told her the right message so she won't fuss me. Do you get your grandson often?
No, he's in another state, so I don't get him as much as I probably should.
She says get the baby. So
okay.
She's acknowledging that she wants you to see your grandson more. She says watch the baby, but I'm thinking that she's meaning for you to see him more.
Okay.
Yeah. So
okay,
I don't know if there's
cool.
any way to make that happen. Maybe you need a little vacation, you know, go visit him. I'm not sure how your schedule works, but And she also says her phrase to me is, does she need a reason to visit?
Okay.
So I guess you're questioning why she's been coming in your dream. She's just like, why I need a reason to visit?
No, she don't need a reason. I just thought maybe she had a reason because she showed up with these babies and I didn't know where they was coming from. So I just wanted to make sure that she ain't have a reason other than just showing up.
I don't know. She said, watch the baby. That's what she told me.
Okay.
And look, you didn't even tell
okay.
me you had a dream that she bought babies, but she told me to tell you to watch the baby.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Jazz.
Quatita, were you saying something? Did you pick up something?
Yeah, I wanted to ask because you said 8 to 10, and I'm like, could it be, you know, were you picking, could you have been picking up on, like, months? You know what I'm saying? Because I thought you were very, you know, on point. I just was wondering did it have to be years? You know what I mean? Or
no, it didn't have to be. No, it don't have to be years. It could be 8 to 10 months. But she showed me a little light skinned boy, and he looks like he's about 8 to 10. So I don't know who this little. It's a cute little light skinned boy with some cute curly hair. So I don't know who this boy is, but she specifically showed me a boy with a lighter complexion. And curly hair, thin, little boy. And he looks like
that
he can be between
like
the ages of 8 and 10.
Right. So that's how her grandson looks. He's just a baby. You know what I mean? So I don't know. Maybe you're seeing him here in a few years. So, but thank you so much, Ms. Reynolds, for calling in. You
thank
know
you.
I love you and I always appreciate you. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and jump on back in. Let's see who else we got. Caller, last four digits is 9673. Who do we have on the line to talk to, Jasmine?
Shauna.
Hi, Shauna.
How are you?
Pretty good. Do you have a question or did you want to connect with an ancestor?
I want to know if I'm making the right move as far as career.
For some reason, I'm getting the word change. Are you changing careers or are you in a current career that you're thinking about changing?
I just put a notice in at my current job, but I'm second guessing myself.
Why are you second-guessing yourself?
I don't know. I guess because
I'm
comfortable
for a long
where
time?
I am.
Yeah.
It's been a little
you
over
need change.
2 years.
Okay. Do you feel like they're not appreciating you where you work at?
Yes.
Yeah.
But I also know the grass is not greener.
So you know what I'm about to say, right?
No.
You just said it. So look. You did something. You stepped in. You stood up for yourself. You stepped into your power, and you said, hey, okay, I don't feel like I'm being appreciated here. I'm going to make a change. I'm going to end my career here and go somewhere else. You put your notice in. And I feel like you've been thinking about this for a little while. Okay, so you decided to believe in yourself, and there's nothing wrong with that. I just don't want you to walk into the next situation and think that you made a bad choice when, basically, I don't want you to quit this job and go to another job and feel like you made a mistake by quitting this job when actually quitting this job is probably the best thing that you've done.
Okay.
You get what I'm trying to say? So I want you to be confident in your decision. You're going to be okay.
Okay.
Changing your mind and staying at the same place changes nothing. They're still not going to appreciate you. I feel like, I mean, I don't know what type of work you feel like, but I feel like it's a lot of, in most workplaces it is, it's a lot of bull going on, it's a lot of gossip going on, a lot of clicking going on, and, you know, I don't know. I just don't feel like, for some reason, I feel indecisive with your spirit. I feel like your spirit is just indecisive. Like, you really don't know what you want to do. But,
probably.
But I think the best decision anybody else can ever do is doing what they feel is best for themselves. And if you feel like they were not treating you right, then you make the right decision. Now, when you go into another situation, it may not feel the best at first, but I want you to try practicing something, and that is to make the best out of everything, no matter where you are, and you'll look at things a lot differently.
Okay.
Watch your thinking. Your thoughts are very powerful.
Okay.
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 All right. Thank
all
you.
Right.
No problem.
Thank you. We appreciate it. All right. So, Ms. Jazz, you all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. Uh-huh.
You need a minute? You need a break?
No, nope,
okay.
I'm good.
For me to keep going. Okay. All right, but we're going to keep going. Last four digits is 7460.
Hello.
Hey, caller.
Hello. Hey, how are y'all?
Hi, how are you? What's your name again?
My name is Tiana.
Sienna?
Yes, ma'am, with a T.
Oh, Tiana. Gotcha.
Uh-huh.
Would you like a mediumship question, or do you just have a question?
Well, I actually have a mediumship question. My friend, who's recently passed away, like a year ago, I keep having dreams about her. Keeps coming to me in my dreams, and I'm just trying to see, like, what is she trying to say?
Okay, hold on just for a second. Let me try to connect.
Okay.
Deanna, to make this easier, give me a name.
Shay.
What'd you say?
Siobhan. Her name was Siobhan, but everybody called her Shay.
Siobhan. Oh, geez, she's young. Was her death sudden?
Yeah, it was.
Okay, I have her. And you want to know? Do you know anyone with the T name, like a Thomas or something like that?
Yeah.
Who's Thomas?
She
or
has
the
a cousin named Thomas.
Okay. She's making reference to Thomas. Do you know Thomas personally? Do you talk to Thomas?
No, we used to go to high school together.
Gotcha. Bear with me.
Mm-hmm.
Thomas, red card. She's talking about a Thomas and a red card. The phrase that I'm hearing for her mostly is she talking. She keeps talking about this Thomas character. So I don't know if something's going on with Thomas, but she's also wanting to acknowledge to let you know that she's here, because that's what she. Mm-hmm. That's what I keep hearing. I keep hearing her say, "I'm still here. I'm still here," and for some reason she keeps showing me like a red car. It's like a smaller red car, and it's an older model red car. It puts me in the mind of like an older Toyota, maybe. I don't know.
Well, she actually
with a red car, maybe?
She actually had a car wreck. That's how she passed away.
That's why she's showing me the car. Gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
Have you been feeling down lately?
Yeah, I have.
Bingo. That's why she's coming to you. Okay, I had to get a good grip on her. She's telling me you've been feeling down lately, and she said that she was one that would comfort you sometimes when you would feel down.
Mm-hmm.
So she's wanting you to know that she's still your friend and she's still very much here. You get what I'm saying?
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just, I'm sorry.
It's okay, honey. It's okay, honey. Yeah, she's making me feel as if you're going through a lot. You got a lot going on right now, you know, and then you're sad about some things, and she's coming to you to provide you comfort. You know, she's kind of like, you know, I'm here to give you comfort and acknowledge the fact that she knows that you haven't been feeling your best. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Have you not been getting out as much as you usually do?
Yeah, that's true.
She wants you to get out more. She's telling me live. She's like, she says life is too short. You know, she says, you know, when you guys were in high school, y'all talked about doing a lot of stuff. She's also mentioning traveling, going places.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she just wants you to get back
everywhere.
Yeah, and she wants you to get back to being yourself, and that's why she's coming to you. You haven't been happy lately. You've been down. She wants you to be happy. So that's why.
And
all
right.
Thank you, Miss Tiana. Thank you, Jazz, for giving
thank
her that.
You.
Thank you, Miss Tiana, for popping in and showing support and getting that reading. We have prayed for you. We hope you're feeling better after that and get some kind of closure. Okay, Miss Tiana?
Thank you.
All right, Jazz. We're going to take another break, but when we come back, we go straight back into the phone line. You know, you're doing such a phenomenal work. I just so appreciate you, man. Again, for those who just logging on, Jazz, tell them how they can find you again.
Thank you so much. You can book on my website at www.jazzthemedium.com. You can also like my Facebook page, which is called Jazz the Medium as well. I offer all types of services on there as well, too. www.jazzthemedium.com.
All right, so we're going to take another break. We'll be back with Jazz the Medium right here. You're listening to Soul Sessions Live on A Walk with the Ancestors Radio.
Got an event or going out on a town? Not sure what to wear? Reach out to stylist Asia Jarice. Asia Jarice at iCloud.com or Asia Jarice on Instagram. That is AsiaJurice, styling Nashville's elite.
Yeah. Yo, it's that new right here with. Yo, we about to take it.
Do you need promotion to advertise your business, get your music played on the radio, or promote an event? Reach out to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. We're looking for sponsorship. We have great packages right here. You can get anything you need for all your promotional needs. Reach out to Quatita Dean at 513-328-0061.
All right, we are back. You know, as usual, I have something going on with my body's trying to shut me down for whatever reason. So we're going to jump back in. We got Jazz the Medium on the line. Make sure you check us out each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to jump right back on into the phone line. We got Jazz the Medium on the line. Jazz, you doing okay?
Yep, I'm doing good.
All right, so we're going to go on back in, Jazz. Caller, your last four digits is 7428. Who do we have on the line with Jazz? Hello, caller? Last four digits is 7428.
Sweetie. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
Pretty good. What's your name?
Talanya.
I'm sorry, say that again.
Talanya.
Talanya?
Mm-hmm.
Hi, so do you have a question for me or do you have a mediumship question?
My mom. She's been deceased for 27 years, and she used to come and see me often. And now I don't see her anymore, and I just miss her. And I'm wondering if she's still around me to feel her presence, but I want to know for sure. Could you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I'm just
okay.
Opening up my senses immediately when you started talking about your mom. I smelled sweets. I was going to ask you that she used to bake.
Bake.
I smelled something sweet like cake.
Yeah, she used to bake a lot of cakes.
Okay. Well, I've got her then. I haven't quite gotten her image yet, but she's here. Let me see what she's saying to me. What's significant? Okay, I'm getting 2 months. I'm getting the M. So I'm thinking it's either March or May. Is there anything specific about one of those months? Anything that sticks out about one of those months, March or May? I'm thinking more of March.
March was, March.
Yeah, it's definitely March because she's giving me the number 3, too. Did anything significant happen in the month of March?
Well, my daughter, that when my mom was dying, she was holding my daughter that was born in March. And she was a baby, so my child that she was holding before she died, she was born in March.
Okay. I got it. She's making me feel as if something is going to come to you in March. So she's speaking of the near future. That's what she's telling me.
Something's coming.
Something's coming in March. I feel like it has a monetary value to it, or it could easily be money. And it's weird, and it's hard for me to say because that's tax time, but she's making me feel like it's separate from that.
Oh.
Are you waiting for any monies to come in?
Like a large sum?
No, I wouldn't say a large sum, but larger than usual. It could be useful. I don't feel like you're going to get rich, but you know.
Well, I've been told by another spiritual doctor that I was getting ready to get a large amount of money, but he never said when or how much, but he said there's a large amount of money that was coming to me.
Your mother's telling me something's coming in March, and I'm completely plugged into her. So I will have to separate to see what I see. But she's telling me that something is coming for you in March, and I feel like it's money.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you get some money in March, huh? Does the name Mark or Marcus mean anything to you? An M, then like a Mar. And it could be like a Margaret or a Margo. I really feel like it's like a Mark. Like a Mar. That's the part of the name that's really sticking out to me.
Mar.
And I feel like it's a male. I really, really feel like it's a male.
Can I jump in real quick? The person you're talking to is my cousin. Right, cuz?
Okay.
That's right, cuz.
And
how are you?
You had a good relationship with my mother who was Marian, which is M-A-R.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So just in case that's what that is, that was the first thing that came to my mind when you said that, Jasmine.
Okay.
Was Marian top heavy?
Well, we had kind of got the same boobs, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're all top heavy.
Yeah. I'm muting myself back out, y'all.
I know you fine. Please jump in whenever you want to, Quatita. Please, I'm okay,
okay
with that. Right,
thank
teamwork
you,
make the dream work.
Okay.
I love it. Yeah.
Okay. I want to jump in just for a second because I want to understand this. Did you have to help someone here recently? Are you dealing with someone that is dealing with substance abuse?
Yeah.
You getting somebody substance? I'm getting somebody house fire.
Huh?
I'm hearing something about a house fire. Did somebody recently have a house fire?
Oh, girl, Lord. No, but the kids be playing with fire, and they had caught my carpet on fire. But there's been some day, but they've been here recently. I have to keep, you know, like I've been lighting the fireplace, and they've been going downstairs and putting stuff in the fire. We rebuke that in the name of Jesus.
But you know what? I know that's right. Jasmine, I also keep hearing what sounds like Marquis. So maybe it is not my mother. And there may be another M name that sounds like that. That's a reference, because I almost want to bring it again back to substances somewhere.
Marquis? No.
Wait, so this person that you're helping that's got this substance abuse, are they directly doing the drugs, or are they tied to somebody that's doing the drugs?
No, it's one of my daughters.
One of your daughters?
Her name is M-A-R.
I let her come back home.
Is her name
M-A-R? M-A-R. Marche.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, my
okay.
daughter,
ahead,
her
ahead.
Middle name is Marche, M-A-R.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm muting myself back
okay.
out.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay, I know that Mara was sticking out to me, like, okay, who is this? Okay. Let's see what your mom is saying about your daughter, because obviously I think that's who she wants to talk about.
Yeah, because that was her first daughter, and she spoiled her like that was her child. It was like she just, you know, that was her first grandchild. So they were, she was very close to my daughter.
Well, when connecting with your mom and feeling that energy, I feel a lot of worry. I feel a lot of alarm, like the hairs on the back of my neck are kind of standing up. Question, do you know if your daughter may have been connected to someone who may have been abusive?
She's going through that now, where sometimes she had to put a restraint on him because he's been threatening her.
Your mom is making me, and I feel very uneasy. Your mom is making me feel like she's not very safe. And that's the feeling I'm getting. I feel real uneasy. Like she's not in a good place right now. So,
well,
I don't know where she lives.
I don't like that particular area. And
when I say a good place, I mean like a good place in her life right now. I don't feel like she's very safe.
Yeah.
Your mom is almost making me feel like she's like in danger. I just feel uneasy. Quatita, are you picking up on this? I just feel really uneasy about.
The crazy part is I actually pick up on my other cousin that she keeps trying to come in. Her name was Lovey. She was murdered, and I feel like it's almost a parallel that they keep showing me to make sure that she doesn't go down that same route is what I keep picking up on. I also feel like she has a I'm going to say it this way. They make me feel like she has a feeling of nobody loves me, that kind of thing. And it's not the truth,
yeah.
But that's kind of what she is. You understand that?
Yeah, she be saying that. She says that.
And it's not the truth. You know what I mean? So they don't want to hold on to that too tightly. They just want you to, you know, continue on and helping any way you can, but don't overexert yourself to where you feeling like you're constantly trying to make up for things that you don't even know what you're making up for. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's just because she feels that way does not make it a legitimate, you know, thing. But you can't say that that's not her experience, you know, so.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, what I'm feeling is your mom's energy, you know, and she's just worried, and it's making me feel really uneasy. So that's what I'm feeling. I just feel really uneasy, like the hairs on my arms are standing up, so I feel uneasy about your daughter's situation.
My daughter came in the room and asked me just before I called, had I talked to her? And normally she'll stay in contact with me, but I just really don't know what's, because she don't really open us out more to people outside of her family more so than she do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's what Tita said.
Well, maybe you get in touch with her, you know what I mean? Like, let's see about if you can reach her and get in touch with her to see what's going on and, you know, Just check that out, Talanya.
Yeah, I am. I'm a caller.
All right, well, I love you, and we thank you for calling in, okay?
I love you all too. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, Jazz. Move on, and see who else we got on the line here. Caller last 4 digits is 0750.
Check that out, Talanya.
Who do we have on the line?
All right, cuz. Well,
hello.
Hello,
this is.
Okay, hi. What's your name?
Teresa.
Hi, Teresa.
Hi.
You got a question for me, or you want to connect to somebody?
I don't have a question. It's just up in the air.
It's up in the air.
Mm-hmm.
For some reason with you, I feel like I'm getting words like roadblock or dead end. Do you feel like, how can I word it? Do you feel like you're doing something and you're not moving anywhere and you're trying to, you know, grow, whether it be like career or anywhere in your life?
Yeah,
I feel a block with you. I feel a block with you. And the weird thing about it is I feel it's like in multiple areas of your life. It's not just one.
Yeah, that's true. It's like I left one place and came to another place thinking that it was going to be different, but it still seems the same. Like, I feel like I'm doing a lot, but not seeing progress or anything, like being pushed back.
How have you been feeling lately?
Just, I don't know, questionable.
Yeah, because
like
I get this block.
My outlook is not as bright as it was at first.
Yeah, I feel, when I feel your energy, I feel kind of blah.
Uh-huh.
You know, and this is a perfect message that I give a lot of people. And it's funny because I find it repetitive, so it may be some advice I need to take on my own.
Mm-hmm.
But the way you feel and the way you think drives everything. Our thoughts manifest our creations. So basically, if your mood or your thoughts are not in the highest place, then anything that's put in front of you is not going to look or feel like a blessing. You get what I'm trying to say?
Understandable. That's understandable, and that's something that I try to promote too, especially to my kids.
Yeah.
And I'm not practicing that, so that's what I feel too, you know, at the same time.
Yeah, because I feel like you've got so many blessings in your life and you just don't see them. You see them, but you don't see them, you know? It's kind of like if I ate red velvet cake every single day, after a while, that's red velvet cake. With me, I love red velvet cake, and I ain't had none in a month, and I can't wait. Like, shoot, I want some cake. You know?
Right. Yes.
So sometimes when we...
I signs, but it's like goes over my head, but...
Yeah.
It's hard to explain it. Like, I see it, and I know. I know better, and I see better, and, you know, but it's just like I'm like at a standstill, like at a stop sign or something. You know, but I know I got to continue to go.
The stop sign is you, honey.
Yep.
It's your thinking. Ain't nothing in you. I don't see nothing in your way. I see you standing in your own way.
Okay,
you got the green light. There is no stop. And the goal of that is coming to the decision of knowing that there is no stop sign. There is no stoplight.
Right.
Good.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And also, you might have some Debbie Downers around you.
Yep.
Take them to the curb.
That.
I'm sorry. Okay.
Yeah, I'm eliminating. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, people, and that's the way energy works. You know, two, they can't occupy the same space. So somebody's either going to pull you down or you're going to pull them down, or they're going to pull you up or you're going to pull them up. So you need to get people that, you know, you need to get up to a certain level. And, you know, you need to pull yourself back up because I feel like you're coming down a little bit.
Yep.
Happy
like
thoughts,
too,
some things that make you happy, okay? Watch a funny movie or take yourself out.
Right.
I want to ask a question myself, if I may. Are you having some respiratory breathing issues or something, Miss Teresa?
No, I'm not, but I had a cold for maybe like 3 weeks, but because I don't take any type of medication or any of that because I just don't believe in it or promote it, I just kind of been trying to get through it without that. But I'm now at this point starting to feel better than I have been.
Kind of lingering then. Was it a chest cold kind of? Because it's kind of lingering.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
It's
probably
like that. It was. Going to be drowsy, whatnot, or, you know, sluggish. But
We really appreciate you for calling in, Ms. Teresa. Thank you so much.
And
Ms.
Teresa.
Uh-huh. Thank you. You're welcome.
I'm sorry.
Uh-huh.
Real quick. I don't know if you have any essential oils like peppermint or spearmint. My spirit is just telling me to tell you this. Put some to clear your lungs up a little bit more because you are a little gunky. Put some like really hot boiling water in a bowl. Put some drops in there. If you got some peppermint leaves or some spearmint leaves, you can put that in there too and then breathe it in.
Okay.
That can help break some of that congestion in there.
Okay, I appreciate that because I love essential oils.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I will definitely do that.
Okie dokie.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, guys.
Okay, 7 minutes left in the show. I want her to be able to at least get two more people in. So let's kind of go a little quick. So, Jazz, we're going to see real quick. We got a young lady on the line. I know I've been trying to get him in, so we're going to go to her. 0320.
Hello.
Hey, Miss
Hi.
Penny. Hi, Jazz.
Go with Jazz.
Hey, how
Jazz.
Are you?
Serenity.
Who am I speaking with?
Serenity.
Hi, Serenity. You got such a beautiful spirit, Serenity. What can I do
Thank
for you today?
I wanted to do a general, like an overall reading.
Serenity, overall. The first word that come to my mind when I think of you is finances.
Okay.
With you, Serenity, I see a lot of good things coming.
Like
I see more. I see more finances, basically more income. My symbol for income or money is a door. If I open the door and see a pile of money, I know you'll get a small lump sum. But if I see a flow of money coming in the door, that means that's an increase in income. So for you, I see an increase in your income coming in. And I don't feel like you'll have to work more or work as hard to get this extra money that's going to be coming in, but it will be steady. But for you, my spirit is telling me to tell you to watch your spending, okay?
Right.
Because I see money flowing in, but I see it going out the window. So I'm going to need you to close that window. Watch your spending, okay? So try not to spend too much. Try not to overspend. Try not to, buy like a lot of expensive things and stuff like that. So just kind of be careful what you're spending, try to save a little because it might come in handy later. Are you planning a trip?
I was thinking about going to Atlanta this summer.
I see you near water. Maybe Florida. Have you considered Florida?
I went there already. I was thinking about it.
Okay. I see you near water, so you might need to put some extra money up for a vacation, but I definitely see you taking a vacation. You could go to Atlanta, but where I see you at, there's ocean, and I know ain't no ocean near Atlanta. So I see you near ocean water. So,
right. As far as my career base and my relationship-wise, do you see anything for me?
Are you single?
No.
Okay, so tell me. I see a gentleman. He's probably like a darker complexion. He might have a little weight on him. Is that your boyfriend?
He is darker, but he don't have a little weight. Well, he's like probably 170.
He ain't fat.
He ain't fat.
Now, he ain't fat, but he ain't real thin either. He ain't no pencil either. I don't feel like.
He like 170.
Okay. I don't see him going anywhere right now, honestly.
Okay.
Y'all relationship got its ups and downs like anybody else's relationship has its ups and downs. But right now, I don't see him leaving or going anywhere right now. So I think you are right in the relationship department. Okay.
Okay. I had asked
my Quatita
about
it up a little
my,
bit though.
You was getting some energy about my baby.
You lost the baby?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm seeing a whole bunch of twos. How old was your baby when your baby passed?
I was about to be 3 months.
You were three months pregnant, or the baby was 3 months old?
I was still pregnant.
You were still pregnant?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm seeing two. Did you lose another baby before?
No, but since you're seeing two, Miss Quatita has told me last time I talked to her that she think it's twins pendant for me. Maybe that's probably what you're seeing.
Yeah, I'm seeing two. That's what I see. I see two.
Like coming?
Hold on, let me connect because it's... That baby, it was too soon for you to tell, but I feel like it was a boy.
Yep, she said the same thing.
I feel like it was a boy. And he's with you. He just kind of, I'm telling you, when we lose our baby,
he was
just,
supposed
they
to
stay
be
with
born
us.
On the 10th.
Yeah,
he was
they kind of stay
born
with
on
us.
The
10th. Yeah. But I see two. So that could be that you're having... Oh, okay. Yeah. I see the twins. I see twins. I see them.
That's exciting. Yes, it is. My boyfriend is a twin.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I was wondering because with you, I just keep seeing the number two, like two. Okay, where is this two? And then, yeah, I see twins, and I think they might be, I almost feel like it might be a boy and a girl. I wish I know you, because I like to be posted to see if I guessed it right. You know, I feel like it's going to be a boy
it's
and a girl.
It's so crazy. Y'all both saying the same stuff, because Ms. Quatita said the same thing, and she said she think I should conceive in February. That's crazy. Y'all both said the same thing, a boy and a girl. And I just wanted to be able to reach out to my son because on my due date when it came up, I was just real upset. I had text Ms. Quatita late night, too.
Yeah. That's okay. It's okay. The only thing I want to add and understand is I don't know if it's due to that. Did y'all just have a big argument, you and your boyfriend?
We was broke up for a year and a half. We just got back.
I mean, over
together.
This last week. Yeah. I mean, like over this last week.
Past week. No, not really. I mean, he's in jail, so we really haven't been arguing. I've just been trying to make sure he's getting out and we back on the right path and stuff. So.
Well, this is what I want to say because if that's the case, because I keep feeling like a fight. So I just want you to make sure that you keep all your emotions where they should be, and that you're not that you don't take it out. Is he pending getting ready to get out though?
Yeah, on Sunday.
Oh, so in this.
So
week,
you got to get
so
you about to
get on his
pregnant.
Damn,
everybody saying that.
You about to get pregnant.
And don't be sitting on his nerves. Okay.
You about to get pregnant.
All right. Well, we're going to let another caller get in before time is out so they can reach with Jasmine. Okay, Serenity?
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am, Queen. Thank you. All right, we're going to take another caller, Jazz. Thank you so much for your time. I don't think we've done this caller yet. It's kind of hard for me to keep up. I'm going to have to find a different system. Caller, last 4 digits is 9709. Who do we have on the line?
Hi, you have Shekinah on the line.
Hi, Shekinah.
Hi.
Hey, so do you have a question for me, or do you want me to try to connect with an ancestor?
You know, I would like to know what is going on in this love life, and I would love to know what's going on in my career. Am I making the right moves, and what moves need to be made?
Okay, let's start with your love life.
Yeah, that's more important.
You've been single for a while?
Yes, I have been.
I see somebody coming for you. When he coming? I see somebody coming for you, and I get a real good feeling about this one. I see somebody coming for you, and I feel like he'll be able to provide most of the needs that you, or most of your desires. You know, he'll be able to. I don't know, I almost feel as if you desire, should you want a man, you want somebody that could, you know, take care of you and help you out. And I feel as if he's going to be able to do that. So I see somebody coming, and if I was to give it time, I would say within the next year to year and a half. I feel somebody,
ooh,
let me see. Me.
Them eggs like to fry it up, I said, goodness gracious.
That's what I'm feeling. I'm feeling like within the next year, year and a half. That's what I'm feeling.
So
we can have Quatita come in and see what she's picking up. But I'm feeling like the end of 2020 going into 21.
God dang.
Year, year and a half. That's what I'm feeling. Yeah. That's what I'm getting. I'm sorry, not 2021. I'm sorry, 19 going into 20, maybe about going 2020. This is put in the middle, 2020-ish. He coming though, girl. He coming.
So,
he coming.
Anything worth talking about with the guy I'm seeing now?
No. I mean, I feel like he's fun. Are you enjoying yourself?
Up and down. You know, my thing is everybody just disappears. It's like I can never find anybody that likes to communicate with me. I feel like all the guys in the beginning, you know, act like they, because that's important to me, and then either they completely ghost or just the communication turns off.
You're a very educated woman, Miss Shakina.
You know it. Mm-hmm.
The word I'm getting for you is intimidation. Some of them just might be a little bit intimidated.
I've called him before, and the thing is, like, in every aspect of my life, people just go, and it's really difficult. I mean, relationships, work, family, like, it has taken me probably 15 years to not get my family to, like, when we have an argument, not smile at me and not talk to me for months.
Now,
so it's difficult to deal with.
Do you tend to hit below the belt?
No, but I think I tend to say the truth, and I have learned that the truth is far more hurtful. But, you know, they're angry if I give an opinion. They're angry if I don't say anything.
How do you
and they
deliver
don't mind
the truth?
And whatever to me.
How do you deliver the truth? I'm just saying you feel a little feisty to me. How do you deliver the truth? You feel me? What's the delivery? You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I can tell you something in so many different ways if you fucking up. I could just come at you raw and be like, hey, you fucking up. You ain't shit. Or I can be like, hey, you know, like the path you're on right now, you know, you're not going, you know. It's just different ways that you could say. I feel like you a sharp shooter. You kind of like, you say it.
Yeah. I definitely am. I have learned about sugar, but I have what irritates most people when they come back to me and say is, like, I'm never disrespectful, I'm never mean, I'm never inconsiderate. It just hurts.
It hurts you?
No, it just hurts them. Like, whatever I said was just truth that they didn't want to deal with. So no one ever comes back and is like, oh, you know, you did this to me, you did that to me, you, you know, did something hurtful to me. They just didn't want to deal with whatever the issue was at the time. You know, I'm surrounded by a lot of people that when a problem arises, they want to take a few weeks or a few months to think about it. And I'm like, no, say how you feel now.
Does that bother you that they feel a certain type of way about the advice that you give?
Yes, very much. Because, you know, don't come to me and ask me for help or to fix it. Like, I'm the only reliable person that I know. I don't have anybody that I can rely on. My mom is starting to step up a bit, but all of them come to me because I'm the person. If you want something or you want something done or you want it done right.
Okay.
But it's definitely not mutual.
Yeah, this is what I'm getting for you. I love your energy. It's very raw, by the way.
Same.
First thing I want to tell you is I want you to be you unapologetically. It's okay. Don't feel bad for who you are. You know, that's just your delivery. But also I want you to kind of use discernment when you give advice because you know your delivery. Like me, I'm a sharpshooter too. So I can kind of feel when somebody can't handle it. So if somebody can't handle it, I just keep my opinion to myself. Another thing I want to tell you is that I want to talk to you about The ego is a defense mechanism and is there to protect us, but the ego is also the ego when it's on a rampage, it can also not be so great. So I look at the ego like a dog. So when you outside and you walking your dog, are you walking your ego or do you see somebody that their dogs are dragging them down the street? You know what I'm saying? So my advice to you is, okay, who's walking the dog? You know? So if you're feeling emotional about the way people act to your advice, that's ego. You see what I'm trying
Meaning
to say?
Meaning like, do I feel like I have to be right?
Right. Or do you, once you give your advice, it shouldn't matter how they feel. You gave it. But you should use a little bit more discernment when you give advice. You feel me? If they feel mad at you or they don't want to talk to you for telling them the truth, you know, that's on them. It shouldn't bother you. But if I were you, I would kind of make sure, like, my ego's in the right place. You know, sometimes we got to, and I struggle with that, too, all the time, especially with my family, you know, kind of checking my ego, because I'm the go-to person in my family too, and they don't care for my bluntness either. So I relate to you very much, and sometimes I got to check my ego. I really do. I got to sit down and say, okay.
Make it hard for them to come to me because I am like rubbing stuff in their face or something like that.
Not necessarily rubbing stuff in their face. I mean, sometimes the ego can be too defensive or too aggressive or too opinionated, maybe. And sometimes when we're like that, it comes out nasty. So it might come out fucked up. You get what I'm trying to say? I'm sorry for cussing, but I don't know no other way to say it. Sometimes, you might be telling somebody the truth. Like, prime example, I had a home patient, you know, and her sugar was through the roof, you know, and I had to straight up tell her, you know, she was fucking up. You know, when I tell her nicely, like, Miss So-and-so, your sugar's 500, you're going to go into, she wouldn't hear me. But when I said, Miss So-and-so, you fucking up and you going to die, she heard me. Her sugar's at 500. But I'm just saying, sometimes you just got to watch her delivery. Because some people can't handle that straight stuff. You want to help people, you got to, but, you know,
sometimes
be you unapologetically, though.
Yeah, I've definitely working on it, praying on that. So I appreciate that feedback.
Well,
thank you so much, Miss Shekinah.
We appreciate you calling and speaking to Miss Jasmine. We only got a few minutes left in the show, so I'm gonna have to kind of end it there because I don't want you guys to run out of time, but I appreciate you calling in and getting that info.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Yes,
thank
ma'am.
You.
Jazz, we are at the end of the show. You did so awesome as usual, which I knew you would. I really appreciate you for coming, you know, on and doing your thing. I hope this isn't the last time you do it. You know, I would like to, you know, at least have you on once a month. If that's something that you're good, you know, with, we can definitely hook it up and have you on at least once a month.
Oh, please. I am honored, and thank you. Thanks so much for asking me to be part of your platform. I love it. I love your followers. I'm always checking you out. You know, you just got some, you got some dope folks, you know. So,
yes.
You know, your
you
show,
too,
show
girl.
Is dope. I love it. You know,
your
you know, I like it raw.
So
I like it straight to the point.
When you give it straight to the point, so your energy has been so live, like you done cut my live off and messing with my stuff so much tonight. The energy has been crazy. But one more time, Jazz, tell the people how they can get in touch with you for a private and personal session.
Okay, if you want to get in touch with me for a private or personal session, you can book at my website at www.jazzthemedium.com. You can also like my Facebook page and hit me up on my Facebook page at Jazz the Medium as well. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Listen, thank you so much again for coming on. And again, I really want you to do it at least once a month. But this is the thing, and I just want to, you know, if you down for it, just let me know. I want to also let you know that I'm trying to put together something in April, and I know we all were speaking about doing something. I'm wanting to do a couple things, but I'm particularly putting together an event here in Nashville that you're definitely welcome to come to. I have a therapist that'll be coming down from Virginia, Miss Reynolds, and I really pray that you'll be part of that as well.
Oh, you know I love you. Anything you do, I'm in. Okay, so just keep
yes,
me posted
ma'am.
On the dates and stuff because I still work full time, so I gotta you know put my time
okay.
in. But anything
okay.
you do, I'm in.
Okay, well, yes, ma'am. I thank you so much again. I'm looking forward to having you on again, Jasmine. I appreciate it.
Thank you. I'm excited. Thanks so much.
All right, y'all. This has been a great-ass show. I'm just so excited. Like our Facebook Live has been on and off. It's trying to reconnect again as we speak. Jazz did her thing tonight. Make sure you check us out each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The energy has been crazy tonight. I'm going to just, you know, leave y'all with that and hope that you come back again this Sunday. Well, I'm praying that I can get another guest reader on. I'm going to link up with her when I'm done and reach out to her and see if she's available to do it as well. I'm always trying to give a platform, share my platform, you feel me, because I'm just blessed to be able to do it. I'm blessed to know these people. You're listening to a Walk with the Ancestors radio. This is Soul Sessions Live. I have been your host, Quatita Dean. Great big thank you and shout out to Jasmine. Miss Jazz, the medium, she came on and did her thing. Listen, this is not an easy thing to do, y'all. And she came on and she's a beast at it. And I'm just so grateful for that. Make sure you check her out at www.jazzthemedium.com if I'm saying that correctly. Thank you. She also has a Facebook like page, Jazz the Medium. So check her out, y'all. I'll see you guys again Sunday. Thank you. We are out.
Do you need promotion to advertise your business, get your music played on the radio, or promote an event? Reach out to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. We're looking for sponsorship. We have great packages right here. You can get anything you need for all your promotional needs. Reach out to Quatita Dean at 513-328-0061. Got an event or going out on the town? Not sure what to wear? Reach out to stylist Asia Jarice. Asia Jarice at iCloud.com or Asia Jarice on Instagram. That is AsiaJurice, styling Nashville's elite.
Hey, you're listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio.
I am your host, Quatita Dean, and this is Soul Sessions Live. You can find me on Facebook at Quatita, Yes, I Am a Queen Dean, on IG at queens_domain1, or you can call or text 513-328-0061 to schedule your appointment today. Remember, heaven is only a call away. To schedule your individual session, group, or party with me, Quatita Dean, the Ancestral Interpreter, call 513-328-0061 and get connected today. Remember, heaven is only a call away.
About your office. Is it just a space for your company, or is it a space to help you grow your company? From new HQs to satellite offices, with WeWork, you can find a space that works for you. Visit we.co/spacematters to learn more.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly!
When it comes to safety, nothing is more important than your vehicle's brakes. If it's hard to stop or you hear squealing or grinding noises during braking, stop by O'Reilly Auto Parts. You'll find the brake parts you need from trusted brands like BrakeBest and BrakeBest Select at everyday low prices. Play it safe with brakes from O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.